As a bridge connecting Europe and Asia, Turkey sits in between two worlds. While the Middle East is undergoing a dramatic transition, Europe is as calm as it has ever been. Should this peace be disrupted, the changes that would occur in the Balkans and the Black Sea would affect Turkey, and thus determine its geopolitical objectives in Europe. My name is Shirvan and welcome to Caspian Report. Although most of the landmass of the Republic of Turkey sits in Asia, its heartland surrounds the Sea of Marmara in the west. This area exists of mostly flat terrain and fertile plain that is home to a large community. The city of Istanbul, which has long played a central part in history, is home to nearly 15 million people and is the grand prize of the Marmara Heartland. It forms the economic, cultural, and scientific center of Turkey. The location and shape of the Marmara Sea encourages trade, a singular political structure, and an extrovert culture. As such, Istanbul has historically functioned as the seat of power of empires. However, access to the Marmara Sea is restricted by the Dardanelles and the Bosporus Straits. In some places, the choke points are a few hundred meters across. This means that any power that seeks to reach the Turkish heartland must make an amphibious assault on the outskirts and then fight against a highly determined and well-equipped Turkish force that can resupply itself by land and sea. This is a nearly impossible task. Moreover, the Turkish heartland is also a trading hub. It links the Black Sea with the Aegean and from it the Mediterranean. But it also connects Europe to Asia by land. Thus, the Sea of Marmara grants the Turks significant influence to dictate the terms of trade over the Black Mediterranean seas as well as the European-Asian land passages. However, sitting at the nexus of trade does not mean that Turkey can unilaterally limit access to foreign powers. Such a decision would provoke foreign incursion against the Turks and nullify the commercial advantages of the Marmara Sea. By virtue of geography, the Marmara Sea is tied to regional interests. As a result, the Turkish heartland is capital-rich, politically unified, and secure. On the other hand, regional disputes often directly and indirectly affect Turkey as well. These characteristics indicate that Turkey cannot afford a foreign policy that encourages indifference or isolationism. The country briefly experimented with an isolationist policy following World War I and the Great Depression when Turkey moved its capital to Ankara. However, by 1946, the Soviet Union had strengthened as much as Turkey had weakened. The former stationed troops on the latter's borders in the Balkans and the Caucasus, and it wasn't long before the Soviets gained influence in Iraq and Syria as well. As Turkey found itself surrounded by the Soviet Union, Ankara became increasingly anxious and joined NATO. In the process, it became a dependency of the United States. By the end of the Cold War, the Soviet Union disappeared from Turkey's borders, and in the ensuing power vacuum, new conflicts broke out in the Balkans and the Caucasus. For Ankara, the transitions of the 20th century demonstrate that stability is not set in stone, and that geopolitical vacuums of power accelerate dramatic changes that can overwhelm even the most formidable nations. It also displays that Turkey, whether it likes it or not, is tied to events in the region, and therefore cannot remain indifferent to its surroundings. In other words, Turkey must follow a proactive policy and block foreign powers from encroaching on its proximity. As things stand today, Ankara's focus is not required in Europe. The Balkans is home to dozens of ethnicities. Every nation has made a bid for supremacy, and those who are incapable have sought favor with outside powers. Nearly every faction has disputes with another, and most groups are split from within. The result is a web of alliances and coalitions that has destroyed empires. Turkey has no appetite to sit in the middle of these bitter disputes. Plus, today the situation is as stable as it has ever been, since nearly all the nations of the continent are EU and NATO members. These Western institutions have provided the Balkans with stability, which has benefited Turkey. However, should this stalemate cease to exist, regional powers would be free to re-engage with one another. Just as the collapse of the Sykes-Picot Agreement has rendered the borders of Syria and Iraq invalid, so too would the fall of NATO and the EU destabilize the Balkans. In such a scenario, Ankara would be left with no choice but to act and fill the vacuum of power in its neighborhood before other rivals do. Elsewise, it would risk a repeat of the encroachment it experienced during the Cold War. In this context, the Balkans present Turkey with several contingency objectives. The Balkan Mountains in Bulgaria cross from west to east and join with the Rodopi and Rila Mountains. The steep elevation effectively detaches the southern portion of Bulgaria from the rest of the European continent and merges with the Marmara region. In historic relation, the flat terrain between Turkey and Bulgaria was known as Thrace. Meanwhile, during the Ottoman Empire, southern Bulgaria was designated as Eastern Rumelia, and it happens to host a significant ethnic Turkish population. Should for some reason the EU or NATO fall apart, Turkey would need to rapidly secure its western front and anchor itself against the Balkan Mountains. This could unfold in many ways. For instance, Ankara could either reach an understanding with Sofia by economic or diplomatic means, which would require time and patience, or the Turks could outright seize the Bulgarian capital by mobilizing the military along the Maritsa River to Sofia. Regardless of how the situation unravels, considering the history, geography, and demography, securing southern Bulgaria is a vital geopolitical objective for policymakers in Ankara. What happens next depends on the post-NATO environment. If there is no significant adversary in the west or north, the Turks can stop in Bulgaria. However, should a new rival power emerge in the region, then Turkey will need to act accordingly and acquire an additional buffer zone. At this point, the most obvious procedure would be to move further north and secure the Danube Valley lodged between Bulgaria and Romania. Here, Turkey needs to fortify itself against the geographic elements in the region. Two points are necessary in this framework. In the north, where the Carpathian Mountains meet the Black Sea, the adjacent Danube Delta leaves a minor traversable gap near the city of Galat. This site, known as Bessarabia, allows a small concentrated force to hold off a larger body that seeks to travel south. It marks an indispensable defensive point against a northern power. If Turkey could manage to secure this gap, it would maximize its position against the numerically superior Russian forces. It would also allow Ankara to reap the benefits of the entire watershed trade of the longest navigable river in Europe. This would be a remarkable prize in its own right. Another strategic point is where Serbia, Romania, and Bulgaria meet along the Danube. Here, the Carpathian and Balkan Mountains encroach on the river and form a strategic canyon known as the Iron Gates. Whoever controls this site will restrain the advances of any Western power. In addition, the Turkish Navy could use the Danube River as a supply line to sustain a military presence by the Iron Gates and the gap in Bessarabia. Altogether, this geographic layout is simply in favor of Turkey. Should NATO or the EU collapse, then Turkey would have to figure out a way to secure the strategic points in the Balkans. Accomplishing these hypothetical objectives is best reached through a mutual beneficial arrangement between Turkey, Bulgaria, and Romania, as opposed to a military occupation. Taken together, the Carpathian Balkan Mountains, Bessarabia, and the Iron Gates, supported by the Danube River, would give Turkey a solid buffer zone against any adversary from the west and north. Historically, the Turks, once they secured Bulgaria and Romania, took a geopolitical gamble and moved into the Pannonian Basin further west. This contested plain was inhabited by many groups that were well capable of defending their interests. To fully occupy the region, the Ottoman Empire had to secure the western gate to the plain, which was held by the city of Vienna. After much struggle, the campaign ended in defeat for the Turks. But over time, the locals of the plain also unseated the Austrians. So, to avoid the rhymes of history, the Pannonian Basin is best left as it is. The same principle applies to neighboring Greece. Despite the historic rivalry between Turks and Greeks, the Maritsa River and the Radofi Mountains form a natural boundary between the two. No one is truly interested in disrupting this stalemate. Now, besides the Balkan area, Ankara also has interests in the Black Sea. While the existence of NATO and the European Union stabilizes Turkey's Western Front, the security of the Northern Front depends on Moscow. Should the Russian Federation ever experience another alteration of its borders or implode from within, Turkey would need to react immediately to secure its interests in the Black Sea. Here, Turkey has the finest ice-free deep-water ports. It also has a significant navy that can utilize these advantages. But the single most strategic point of territory that can give the Turks the long-term advantage over the Russians is Crimea. The peninsula splits the northern Black Sea in two pockets and encloses on the drainage of the Don River, which is one of the few navigable waterways in Russia. Crimea is also connected to the Eurasian landmass by a mere 5 to 7 kilometer wide strip of land known as the Isthmus of Perekop. Like in a game of chess, a single fortification can hold off a vast military force. This also means that the logistics of Crimea is dependent on naval supply lines. Whoever controls Crimea will be able to observe, track, harass, and delay the mobility of the Russian forces. It also gives the occupant the power to determine the terms of trade from the Don River to the Black Sea. Essentially, Crimea is the Achilles heel of Russia, and the single most strategic point relative to the Russian-Turkish geopolitical status quo. Should Russia's territorial integrity be ever exposed, it would be in Turkey's interests to immediately seize control of Crimea, thereby placing the Russians on the long-term defensive. To accomplish such a tasking mission, Turkey needs to significantly expand and modernize its navy, which is the subsequent objective. However, since Russia, NATO, and the European Union all exist, Turkey's contingency objectives in the Black Sea and the Balkans are all hypothetical. It is in Ankara's interest to maintain the current status quo, but should the situation change regardless, Turkey would need to change along with it. If history demonstrates us anything, it is that no political entity truly lasts forever. As such, Turkey must maintain a proactive policy, and if the need arises, it must secure the Balkan Mountains, Bessarabia, the Iron Gates, as well as the Crimean Peninsula. To realize such hypothetical goals, Turkey will need to further expand and modernize its naval forces. Taken together, these objectives form the geopolitics of Turkey in Europe. But only a small percentage of Turkey's land area is located on the European side. About 97% of the country sits in Anatolia, which comes with a distinctly different geopolitical landscape. This and more we will cover in Turkey's geopolitical interests in Asia. For now, this was a Caspian Report by me, Shirvan. Special thanks to our contributors on Patreon who voted for this topic and gave us the means to research and produce it. If you want to help our channel to remain independent and self-sustained, visit patreon.com/caspianreport and consider joining our crowdfunding network. You can also make one-time anonymous donations by cryptocurrencies. See the screen for our Bitcoin and Ether address. In any case, thank you for watching, take care, and sarol.